Everybody, welcome back. Driveway drills, quarantine time. We're gonna get through it. Let's check out the video. Everybody, it's Eric Johnson from Arete Throws Nation. And in today's video, what we're gonna talk about is some more driveway training, right? Wherever you can get a hold of some good, smooth concrete. And even if you can't, even if it's just grass or whatever, we're gonna talk about how we're gonna be able to work technique, learn technique through all this COVID-19 stuff and get better and emerge out of this stronger and better than ever. So in today's video, what we're gonna talk about is using something that you can use around the house. And you'll see traffic, this is gonna be the neighborhood. When we're training at home, we can use things like a med ball. Med balls are great for drills. We'll use them with our pillar drills. We'll teach a lot of our throwers how to throw into the wall or into a brick wall or something of that nature. So we're teaching them how to sequence the lower body and how to add power to the punch. Now, one of the other good things that I like about medicine balls, and again, this is nothing new, but this is just an idea for you to do. Now, one of the key things that we talk about in our videos, and we go to our camps, we talk about not finishing the throw. So what does that mean? And because most people, when I say, what do you mean, don't finish the throw? That's how you, the only way you can throw. Well, what I'm getting at is that what you want to do is when you're doing drills, we want to be hitting our throws and we want to be hitting our position and holding the position and learning how the lower body initiates into the finish before the upper body. Now, one of the things that you're going to see is we see a lot of our athletes, they have a hard time not finishing the throw. And so what that means is they hit a position and they come out and they hit here. And what they do is they, instead of stopping like I just did, they do this sort of thing. They go, right? And you see when I do that, especially from here, you can see that as I go, I'm gonna be pulling myself off the delivery leg. Now you're gonna notice I have two chalk circles. The bigger of the two is for the discus, and the yellow circle, if you can see the difference, is for the shot. And so today, what I'm gonna do is talk about not finishing the throw for both, but for the rotational shot, you're gonna see how the delivery works. So what we're gonna talk about is one of the things, again, that we talk about at our camps, and we talk about in training, and we reiterate over and over and over again with all of our throwers, and we see this all the time. It's one of the biggest mistakes, is not finishing the throw. And that means as we do drills, we have to learn how we're gonna create motion from the lower body to get the hips into the throw to be able to push. Now, one of the simple things is when we do anything from a wheel drill where we're here, so you'll notice I'm gonna get here and I'm gonna try to keep everything back. And so now if I'm doing a stand throw, you're gonna see we have our heel up and push drill, and we're trying to initiate that and create that tension through the core. That's really key. So when we go to do another piece in our progression, right, a stand throw and stand throw oriented drills, that's nothing new. But again, what we focus on in the throwing chain reaction system is how to sequence that position. And so that way we're making sure that we're getting the lower body activated correctly into the throw. Now again, we go half turn. So we call it a modified wheel. We're working a drill called a push pull. Where do we set our hips? Where do we have the upper body? And how do we get into this position? So then when we work on something like how we're gonna do a step in, we're gonna be working on sinking. And again, we're gonna be working on not letting the upper body initiate into the throw. So then the third thing is, especially when you go to your fourth, when you're working and you're working through a full throw, the key is you're really gonna see how active you are. And part of the big thing that you wanna be doing is staying back. And so one of the things that we're focusing on is as we're coming through, we're gonna be trying to stop and hold the upper body. That's gonna be super critical, and that's gonna be actually pretty easy. Good thing about the medicine ball for this is in not learning to finish the throw and learning how to create tension by initiating the lower body and holding the upper body for the right timing sequence is gonna be really key. This is, again, one of the things we talk about when we're opening the arm, not the chest. What the medicine ball does is help you feel how to hold the upper body and not make the upper body move simultaneously with the lower body. There does have to be lower upper sequence, lower upper, to create that stretch reflex, whether it's the discus or the shot, and whether it's even the glide. And we'll talk about the glide and the discus in another video, but this is really specifically for the rotational throws, and really specifically I think this is a good drill for the shot. Now here's the thing, if you don't have a med ball, you can take like a gallon jug of water. I forget the exact weight of a gallon of water, but it's roughly 4 pounds. So that would be a lightweight med ball, and that would be a good thing that you could use, and just you could kind of hold that jug and be able to do your movements and kind of get the same type of thing. In fact, the fact that the water is kind of moving a little bit will cause an extra level of making you less stable. So it's actually a good thing, and that's something simple that you can use. Now, if you don't have that, again, get a broom handle and you can sit there and you can kind of feel the same thing and feel how the broom handle is going to stop. Again, we use our TCR drill bands. You can get those. We have those in the link below, and we'll be able to have you staying long and being feeling this, or we can set and have, again, feeling this. And what you'll be surprised is, as many of you start this drill, you hit this position and you keep going because the sequence is too active with the upper body too early. We wanna be active, we wanna be aggressive, but we have to do it in the right window. Okay guys, so hopefully that helps today's video. Remember, I know everybody's in lockdown, we're only a few weeks in, it's stir crazy. Some of the information that we're getting doesn't look always the best at how long this is gonna last, and a lot of you guys lost seasons. Remember, you can use this time, sit around and be super bummed out about it, or you can be more proactive and do something. And that's what we're encouraging here, and that's why we kind of switched up our setting to show you, as long as you've got an area to move and turn and you can draw a circle, and even if you can't, even if it's just grass, you can get a ton of work done, and that's a good thing. So if you guys like this, give it a thumbs up. Any questions or videos you'd like to see, be sure to comment below, and we will see you on the next video.